So what you're asking yourself to do here goes against your entire biology. I studied to be a clinical psychologist. And when I got out of grad school, I owed $100,000 in student loan debt. And I saw a friend of mine within 1 year make $100,000 trading stocks. And I thought, well, what a brilliant idea for me to do to get out of debt. I had a fabulous 2 months, and then the tech bubble burst. And that's what really got me interested in financial psychology, trying to figure out my own financial psychology. And the crux of my research is trying to figure out, what are these beliefs around money, where do they come from, and how can we shape them to better our financial lives? We've identified beliefs that are associated with money that predict all sorts of things, like how much money you make, your net worth, your financial behaviors. Our behaviors around money are driven by what we call money scripts. And these are beliefs that we have gotten quite often directly from our parents. Sometimes they go back for generations and they're passed down to us. So once you've been able to identify your money script and where it came from, then you need to start asking yourself, how is this helping me or hurting me? We know we should save for the future and not spend more than we make. And a huge part of that really involves activating and engaging your emotional brain. And a really powerful way to do that is to create visual images of your goals. What is it you want? Is it a place you want to live? Is it a home? Is it an early retirement? Is it college savings for your kids? We used this technique actually in a study. People increased their savings by 73%. So what you're asking yourself to do here goes against your entire biology. And the best way to do that is to get really excited about why you're saving to begin with. It'll give you the motivation to push through that barrier to taking action.